In the previous section, we talked about the unit of concentration of molarity. In this section, we want to look at some other units of concentration. And I'm not going to say that these units of concentration are useless, because they're certainly not. They're used all the time in professional ways, but they're not used very often in this course. In fact, the only other unit of concentration that's used extensively in this course is molality, which we'll talk about far later on. But here, we're looking at some other units of concentrations like mass percentages and volume percentages. These are very common in the healthcare industry. Parts per million and parts per billion, these are very common in environmental science type of applications. So I do want to give you an idea that they exist and give you one example of mass percent, which we actually use in the lab course here, not so much in the lecture, but in the lab course. And so you just have one example of, you know, how this stuff can be useful. So mass percentage, or volume percentage, is the mass of the component, the part, divided by the mass of the solution, the whole, or the volume of the solute over the volume of the solution, which is the part, again, but divided by the whole. So, and of course, they're times 100 because they're percentages. So again, these are used often in the healthcare industry. Parts per million is mass of solute over mass of solution, the part divided by the whole, times 10 to the 6, 10 to the 6 being a million. Parts per billion is the mass of the solute divided by the mass of the solution times 1 billion. So if the solution is water, this is usually considered as a milligram per kilogram. And in fact, it doesn't have to be water for that to be the case. So this is a milligram per kilogram. So if something is one part per million in water, that means there's 1 milligram of it in a kilogram of the water sample or the solution. If it's a part per billion, that's a microgram per kilogram. So that's, again, if you have a kilogram of water, that's 1 microgram per kilogram. Here, we're going to look at a mass percent question. But like usual, we're going to do it on a piece of paper as opposed to doing it on the slide. So it wants to know the mass percent of NaCl if 3.729 grams of NaCl is dissolved to make 75.161 grams of solution. And this is right out of our lab manual. So this is what we do in the second experiment here. We look at the conductivity of salt water using different mass percent solutions of salt water. So remember that a percentage is the part divided by the whole. But the mass percent, which is always often abbreviated percent m divided by m, is equal to the mass of the solute, in this case NaCl, divided by the mass of the solution times 100. In this case, the mass of NaCl is given 3.729 grams, divided by the mass of the solution, which is 75.161 grams times 100. Let's look at sig figs. We have 4 here. We have 5 here. So our answer should have 4 significant figures. And this comes out to be 44.961 to 4 sig figs percent. So this is an application of mass percent, again, taken directly from the lab manual we use here in General Chemistry 1. So this just gives you a few examples of some different types of concentrations that are used in different industries or for different applications. But in chemistry, as you saw in the previous section, we mostly stick with molarity.